Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dotes. In this year's Halloween special, I decided to make a demon, and I'm not talking about just any demon, since this time I will show you how I make Power from Chainsaw Man. She is one of my favorite characters in the manga, along with Denji, with a design that attracts a lot of attention, and by that I mean her entire face in general. I was very excited to know that the manga will have an anime adaptation which will be premiered next year, and believe me, I'm freaking out with that trailer. It was amazing! I cannot reveal many details of this character since that will be a spoiler. I'm just gonna say that she's a demon, she hates humans, and she's one of my waifus. But seriously, if you like shonen manga with action content and gore, I fully recommend you read Chainsaw Man. It is absolutely incredible, for real. If you follow me on Instagram, you will know that I shared the concept art of the character, giving it my own personal touches. This is the first time I made a doll with horns, which made me a bit anxious and at the same time intrigued to know the result of as it will be. But hey, each new project is a new experience, and I hope to achieve something incredible for you guys. So, without more to say, let's get started! To make Power, I will use a Poison Ivy doll from the DC Superhero Girl line as a base. I mentioned it before, but I really love these dolls a lot because of the articulated torso. And also, I choose her because her features are perfect for the face of the character. So, to begin, the first thing I will do is remove the head from the body in order to continue with the rest. With her head out of her body, I take my scissors and I start to cut the hair curl to the roots, so that I can remove the hair from the inside with a flat screwdriver, and then remove everything with tweezers. With a cloth socket in acetone, I begin to remove the makeup from the doll, trying not to leave any mark of paint, staying this way. Now with the scalpel, I will remove her lids since I don't need them because I will modify her mouth later. And yeah, it looks a bit weird without them. God, I hope to know what I'm doing. Now with a marker, I will mark the guide point where I will put her horns, trying to make them well positioned on the head. Off camera, I cover the doll's head with plastic, and now with a fine wire, I will make the structure of the horns, staying like that, as you can see. Alright, the time has come to use the epoxy skull, which consists to take these two pieces and make them the same size, and then mix it all. And with that, I will mold them on the head. Power horns are very straight and pointed, and achieving that result at the beginning was a bit complicated, but I think that in the end I achieved something acceptable since I can improve them in the same way, sanding them more. With the horns already dry, I will cover them with a layer of dark red paint. The necks will be a bitter red since I want them to have a gradient effect. And now with a bit of neon paint, I will pass them to the tips. Since I did the Lyra, I really like that effect, and I must tell you that the result is wonderful. It gives more light to the piece. With that, it's time to do her hair. And for that, I will use this yarn color that you see here, along with other colors that I worked with before, and make a mix of blondes. But I decided that I'm going to dye it a little so that it has a more pinkish tone. And for that, I will use a red watercolor mixed with water, and I will pass them to the well with a brush. To speed up the process a bit, I will dry it with a hair dryer, staying this way. And for the color to spread better, I will be combining it and dry it at the same time. It doesn't matter if the color falls a little, the important thing is that it has a mixture of both tones. And as you can see, I already stored all the hair in a Ziploc bag. And now I can do her hair. The head is prepared and ready to put on her wig cap. As you can see, I marked the places where her horns will go. With that, I will be gluing the hair wet from the bottom up, guiding me from the lines that I draw. I must say that there's been some confusion on social media regarding Power hair color, as on the manga coloring pages, her hair looked a bit pink, and now that the anime trailer came out, it was confirmed that Power is blonde. And believe me, I who read the manga also thought that her hair was pink, and more because I see photos of some cosplayers with that hair tone, And with my doll, I want her to have a mixture of both tones without having such an intense shape of pink. Returning to the video, in the upper part I will glue the lighter tone so that it has a degradation. Dark tones in the bottom and light tones on top. I will stop for a moment since I will glue the horns in the space that I marked. And I already removed the excess piece of wire. Now I will re-glue them, putting crazy glue on each one, giving them a little pressure so that it sticks better. And as I expected, the horn has been completely fixed. But for more security, I will protect them with a little epoxy glue on the edges. And as you can see, I don't fill in the head with hair, and it looks long just the way I want it. Which is something that not happens when you use yarn to do this. Now I will start to do her hairstyle, which is not very complicated, since I only have to mold some parts with glue and water, and make some small cuts in the front. And this is how power hair looks. This is the first time I made a wig with horns, and wow, I'm very delighted with this result. I was going to use hairspray when I finished it, but I changed my mind and decided not to use it, since I want the hair half movement in the back. And with that, now I will continue working the rest of the doll. Power breasts are moderately large, and I decided to do the same for the doll's body, as I see her a bit flat and plain for some reason. So I will increase her breasts with a bit of epoxy and I will mold them with my tools. Staying this way, although I think I exaggerated a bit in details. Now with the clay dry, I will go over layers of paint of the same skin tone of the doll. First I will use a sponge, and then with a brush I will go on the next ones. Leaving her breast in this way. Now that I put the head back in place, I'm going to modify her mouth just like I did with Hanako-kun. First, I cover everything I cut using a epoxy skull, and I will make it blending well with the doll's face. Doing this part was a bit stressful since I had to make her mouth look feminine and at the same time fierce, since for power expression I had basic of the concept that I showed at the beginning of the video. With the mouth already made, I take another piece of clay to make her teeth. Power is a demon with a very sharp fangs, and achieving the shape of her fangs was not difficult as I expected, since the toothpick I used helped me a lot. And this is what Power Mouth looks like. I'm glad I made this kind of facial modification again, it makes a totally different change. Off camera, I already painted the doll's face, and now with that it made her mouth look better. Ready with that, I already passed 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear to start drawing the lines of the eyes. I'm completely basing on my concept, since using reference from the manga was a bit difficult for me, and those from the anime are not very specific. And that's how her eye lines look. Now with the red pencil, I'm gonna draw her pupils. One of the things that I like about her is that her eyes have this cross-shaped design, which made her stand out a lot, in addition to her horns and fans, of course. After another coat of spray, I start to touch up putting more base colors. Now I will use chalk pastel to give that touch that makes doll faces look more realistic and striking. A tip, before you seal the blush with MSC, brush on a white pastel base and it will make the color not look so strong after you seal the face. After sealing with the spray, I retouch the lines that I drew more. If you have noticed the patches on my hand, it's because I have an accident in the kitchen of my house which has burned my hand a little with a boiling oil. Don't worry, I'm better now, I just don't want you to see the burn mark that has left me. Now with the black pencil, I will mark her lash lines, which will make her face stand out more. Finished with the pencils, it's time to use the brushes. With white watercolor, I will make the white part of her eyes stand out as well as her fangs. With black paint, I highlight more her teeth, making a zigzag line. And I pass more white to correct my mistakes. Now I will go on to use acrylic paints. With diluted red paint, I'll pass on her eyelashes to give a touch more flashy and weathered. Then I brush on neon paint on the eyes. And with white paint, I put the sparkle effect. None of the characters in the manga have that detail, so I only do it as a personal touch. To finish with the repaint, I protect only the white parts with ultra glass varnish. And this is what Power Face looks like. It looks exactly as I drew in the concept, which is something that leaves me very satisfied. Okay, now let's see how the hair does its magic with this face. Wow, I can't believe it, it's Power! This part is really the most rewarding. If you saw her in person, you will be more shocked. With her face finished, now I'm gonna start working on her clothes. And as you can see, I already have the patterns on her skirt and pants marked on the fabrics. Off camera, I finished sewing the two complete pieces. The fabric of her shirt was a bit difficult to work since it was a bit soft fabric and I had to be careful. Luckily, it was not difficult for me to work her pants. This is how the pieces of clothing look on the doll's body. Power has one side of the shirt held loose, so I did the same by adding some buttons. With black ribbon, I will use it to make her tie. And this is how it turns out in the end. With that, I will make her coat using this blue fabric that you see here, which I will sew it with a needle and thread. Thus leaving her coat. I made the patterns larger so that it can be put more easily. With the same patterns, I made another coat, this time with red fabric, since I've seen so many official arts, fan arts, and cosplays with that look. So yes, this doll will have two coat changes. For her shoes, I will reuse the ones that came with the doll. So with the scalpel, I will remove the parts that I don't need. And off camera, I completely modified them with epoxy and I used craft foam for the bottom part. With that, I begin to paint. First with a white base to fill everything, and with red paint, I will only paint the top part. And that's it. The best thing is that the doll can stand it with them on. Power has the ability to use her own blow to create weapons of any type, and what I will do will be the one that she has on the cover of the volume 2 of the manga, which will be a Sai. As you can see, I made it completely of wood and I joined the parts with crazy glue. Here, as you can see, I used epoxy to seal the part that I glued it. This way, it prevents it from breaking and making a single piece of wood. With the side armored, I will begin to paint with pure red and hi, that is flood. As an extra touch, I also put neon paint on it as I did with her horns. And this is how the side looks. The neon paint seriously gets a unique touch by just painting one side. Also, as a final detail, I made this pointy stick painted with the same finish. And with that, Power is ready! You cannot imagine how incredible it has felt to achieve this result. It is the first time that I made a doll with horns, or rather, a wig with horns for a doll. They are literally things that sometimes I think I will not achieve, and in the end I surprised myself. I really love this character. Giving her my personal style made her look so unique, and I'm very excited to see the anime next year. And if you're interested in me doing Denji too, I'm glad to do so. It makes me happy to be able to release another video for Halloween. In my country, it is an event that is not celebrated at all, since the population always say things like, "Oh, eso es una celebración del diablo," or "Esas son cosas de gringos locos, blah blah blah." Definitely, making videos like that is my way of celebrating with you guys. That and watching horror movies at midnight. So, thanks for watching this video, subscribe to my channel to see more content like this, and also follow me on my other social media. I have many videos in mind that I'm excited to do, and the next character I have planned for the channel is Yuji Itadori from Jujutsu Kaisen. I had already done the logo for the project at the beginning of the year, so it's time to work on that. Well, Feliz Halloween chicos, my name is Eric and I will see you next time. Bye!